The Philippine government's total outstanding debt reaches the 15 trillion peso mark. The Treasury Bureau says the sovereign debt was up by 388 billion pesos in February. It attributed the higher borrowing to debt issuance, which it said was partially tempered by the stronger peso. The Marcos administration has now borrowed nearly 2 trillion pesos since assuming office in 2022. Going back to our top story, we are now joined by Hans Kakdak, officer in charge of the Philippine Migrant Workers Department, for an update on the situation of Filipinos in quake-hit Taiwan. USEC, thank you so much for joining us.
Yes, thank you as well for having me.
USEC, thankfully, initial reports indicated that there were no Filipino casualties. Has this information changed since the initial reports?
It hasn't, in the sense that still no reports on Filipino casualties. We did receive a report of two Filipinos who incurred minor injuries in the two separate counties. But other than that, the previous report pretty much stands. No Filipino adversely affected by the earthquake thus far.
And are there any ongoing efforts to confirm the safety of all other OFWs that could be affected because of the earthquake?
Yes, of course. We are constantly in touch with, first of all, the MECO, Chairman Bellio and his team at the MECO, and we're thankful. And second, we put up a hotline at the DMW, and we are taking in calls. We have not received any calls with respect to reports of adverse cases. However, we have received calls from families who are inquiring about their loved ones, and so right now we're in the process of accounting for the names that the inquiries that we had received. They're not too much at this stage. We received around less than 20 requests, and we're in the process of confirming the status of the OFWs.
And how is the DMW coordinating with Taiwanese authorities and the Filipino community leaders, you know, of course, to get up-to-date information?
Yes, of course. We are abreast in terms of the ongoing efforts of the authorities with respect to search and rescue as well as humanitarian efforts. But having said that, we're mobilizing on our own in the sense that we're reaching out to the Filipino community and also offering our own form of basic needs assistance as well as financial assistance. We do have an action fund given to us by Congress and the President, so we're mobilizing these funds as we speak. And as I said, we've opened a Taiwan help desk at the Department of Migrant Workers. There are Philippine as well as Taiwan hotline numbers. I would just request your station to pick up the numbers and post them or flash them accordingly in your network.
Lastly, USEC, are there any OFWs who were potentially displaced because of the earthquake?
Well, in terms of displacement, we haven't received any reports as well. Taiwan OFWs are mainly factory workers, so they live in dormitories, and we have not received any reports of any dormitories adversely affected. That's about 65% of OFWs. The remaining 35% would be living in households. And there, we also have not received any reports of any OFWs displaced or taken out of households. On the contrary, the trend usually in crisis situations such as this is the households come together and would need our Filipino workers, household workers, more than ever in this kind of situation.
USEC Hans Kakdak, officer in charge of the Philippine Migrant Workers Department. USEC, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.